Hello, my name is Carmen Lozon. I want to thank you for watching me on YouTube and for giving me some of your time. I was privileged enough and fortunate enough to be able to be inside the courtroom today for Murray's arraignment, June 14th, 2010. Numbers were drawn at random by lottery, and I was chosen, so I hope to be able to share some of my insights with you and the things I observed, the things I saw, the things I heard. The reason I'm doing this is because I want to be able to give you, Michael Jackson's fans and supporters, and also members of the general public, a chance to look at things from a hopefully neutral point of view. One of my main criticisms of the mainstream media regarding Michael Jackson is that I don't think that they've given him a fair shake. I don't think he has been presented properly, meaning fairly and openly. I want to give you a chance to compare the observations and notes of someone and what she saw and heard with what the mainstream media presents to you. And going down to the courthouse today, I think with my video footage and photographs and notes, I can give you a reasonable account of what an eyewitness saw. In order to get in that courtroom, I had to hide something that I was given while waiting in line. I would have preferred to display it proudly, but we were told that if we carried these signs, we would not be allowed in. So I tucked it away in my purse. But I know where my loyalties lie. Some people are wondering why Judge Pastor did not restrict or take away Murray's medical license. And I can tell you from having been in that courtroom, he basically was citing a ruling from a previous case. It basically says that he cannot override another judge's decision. He mentioned that as a judge, functions as part of a tribunal, and he cannot override the decision or choice made by a fellow member of that tribunal. Not unless there have been changes made in the circumstances or changes perhaps in evidence. He said there have been no changes in circumstances, and information continues to come in, so at this point in time he is not going to override another judge's decision. Both the prosecution and the defense made their presentations and their case for why they wanted what they wanted. I'm not going to get into that here. I'll get into my notes a little later. But I am trying to give you an objective view. And I know that's very hard for many of Michael's fans and supporters because we tend to have very strong feelings. If you have ever served as a member of a jury in the United States of America, you understand what is asked of us, and that is neutrality, to set aside personal bias, strong opinions, and strong feelings. I went to the courtroom today, or the courthouse. I didn't expect to be allowed in the courtroom. But I went there today trying to be neutral, even though I know what my feelings truly are, what my beliefs and perceptions are. I did not cry, I did not get angry, I didn't yell, I didn't shout. I gave the kind of calmness and neutrality that I would like to see the media give in regards to Michael, the kind of treatment that I think he should have been given. If I can do that as a member of the general public, knowing how I truly feel, I don't see why the mainstream media can't do the same thing. Just report the facts, report what is stated in the courtroom, what is presented. Leave aside personal bias and feelings, and just report the news. So that is what I'm going to do in my upcoming video presentations. I'm going to report what I saw as an eyewitness, what my ears heard, what are in my notes. And I want you, the general public, Michael's fans and supporters, to compare my notes with with what is presented to you by the media. Thank you for watching and for giving me your time.